More than half of all consumer goods contain the same ingredient, palm oil. The palm fruit's derivatives are almost endlessly adaptable. And today, the average person goes through 17 pounds of them every year. But that soaring demand has a bleak downside. Massive deforestation. Millions of acres of rainforest in Indonesia and Malaysia have been cut and burned to clear the ground for giant palm plantations, driving forest species to the brink of extinction. Just one country has managed to take on the industry. Norway. In 2011, Rainforest Foundation Norway launched a campaign under the slogan, "Don't Eat the Rainforest." They directed consumers to a guide showing which foods contained palm oil, so they could boycott them. It galvanized a massive outcry against the food industry. The campaign itself was simple, but Lars Lervell, director of the Rainforest Foundation, said finding out which companies to name wasn't.
Palm oil is used in thousands of foodstuffs, and it can be used in 1% or 30% or 50%, and you cannot often see on the label if there is palm oil in it, because it's often disguised as vegetable fat or vegetable oil.
But Norway has a Freedom of Environmental Information law. It means companies are required to disclose the impacts and ingredients of their products, if anybody asks.
I mean, nobody had really heard about palm oil. It's not a thing that people talked about or knew about before the campaign. So what really happened was that this created enormous interest among children, and in less than a year, palm oil consumption in Norway per capita dropped by two-thirds.
The whole country got involved. On public television, children learned to survey ingredients for palm oil derivatives. Famous bloggers started mass candy boycotts.
Det här ville aldrig ha skett om inte förbrukaren, alltså mig och du, hade visat att man faktiskt bryr sig om miljön och hur godteri och maten vi spiser kommer från.
And the country's biggest supermarket chain released commercials for its palm oil-free foods, starring marching red-eyed palm villains. But the influence of the campaign now stretches far beyond the grocery store. This summer, Norway's parliament passed legislation to stop public entities from using palm oil in biofuels. The problem is that Norway's success didn't put a dent in the global market. In the 3 years after the Norwegian campaign started, production increased around 14% worldwide. According to Emma Learley at the US-based Rainforest Action Network, that's because consumer boycotts have limitations.
When we talk about boycott campaigns, which is what Norway has run, is that sadly, the palm oil market is not diminished by that. If anything, they are continuing to expand into new areas. Ultimately, it's not the responsibility of each individual consumer. It should really be the corporations that are purchasing this palm oil